عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Thank you Mr. Chairman. Thank you to the organizing committee, Dr. Fadlul, inviting me for this important seminar. So I will start my talk on Islam and health, which seems a challenging topic, being continuously subjected to skeptic attitude, as you know. So this is very general, Islam and health. I hope by end of this lecture we will be able to define more the terms about Islam, health, spirituality, and understand the Islamic holistic approach of life and how Islam appreciates science, preserves human life, protects civilization, and how this was very practical all over the time. I will show examples, and to recognize the value of physical purity, healthy food, proper diet, natural remedies, the milestones of what is called Islamic medicine. What is health? There is different definition of health. We can refer to WHO definition, the earlier one, that is complete physical, mental, and social well-being, not merely the absence of disease. But 1937, there was another definition by Jesse Williams, who said that it is a condition of the individual that makes possible the highest enjoyment of life. So this is more social. And the greatest constructive work that shows itself best service to the world, it is focusing more on social side. Dr. Mustafa Arafa is a senior epidemiologist from Alexandria University in Egypt, suggested a new definition that one health means that one never needs the need to be aware of the body. So no signs of pain, no signals of discomfort. This could be the health which is unlikely to be achieved in our modern life. So we have to consider the holistic model of health. There are three models of health, but the holistic one is most practical, which cover the physical and the mental and the spiritual aspects of man. The basic Islamic concepts, we are not here to define what is Islam, but just few words about the basic concepts in Islam. There is only one God. Everything should be directed to Allah, our worship, our actions. And Islam finally comes to teach people how to lead a life of simplicity and goodness, that everyone was created equal. Everyone created equal in the prospect of Islam. So we have to understand that there is no discrimination between mankind. And this comes to be clear when we study the holistic approach of Islam. This is holistic approach of Islam as mentioned in Quran. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. وَابْتَغِي فِيمَا أَتَاكَ اللَّهُ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. This means, don't forget your share of the world. During your journey to the end of the life, don't forget your share in the world. So Islamic Sharia support this. There is no difference between our way of life, whether it is towards Allah or the secular style of life, the earthy one. We have to combine both. This comes from the approach of Islam, as I said, holistic one, where body is to do the practice every practical thing in life. Mind is concerned with faith, and soul is a spiritual concertation. What are the sources and objectives of Islamic Sharia which supports this view? We have the primary sources known to everyone, Quran and Sunnah, primary sources. And we have secondary sources running in that way, consensus, discussion, analogical reason, inference, ijtihad, public interest, local customs. Please, if you refer to this, you will find some of these are modern research methodologies. It depends on the same items. So secondary sources of Islam, Islamic Sharia, supported what is running currently in modern research when we go for analogy and when we go for conclusion and so on. This was mentioned earlier. Sharia aims to protect way of life, life itself, intellect, lineage, wealth and property, this is known. But the peculiar thing of Islamic Sharia that over centuries, this Sharia is continuously formulated, elaborated by successive generation of jurists, and they used all methods of interpretation, analogy, consensus, disciplined research by mujtahid, by those supreme religious leaders, to update and find solution for emerging issues facing us in our modern life. Pearls of Islam, as I suggest, that Islam advocates rational approach of thinking and practice, very logic and mind the things. Examples, in Quran, there is 49 times Quran mentioned the words yatafakkarun, yatadabbarun, yaqilun. This means mind and minding. So, الراسخون في العلم يقولون آمنا به كل من عند ربنا وما يذكر إلا أولو الألباب. Every time we are facing such kind of verses that we have to think, we have to mind, we have to investigate, we have to conclude, and finally we come to conclusion. The same, another evidence from Al-Zumur 18, أولئك وأولئك هم أولو الألباب, those who has people, those are the people of understanding. أولو الألباب. B is, second thing is, Quran appreciates very much science and learning. إقرأ is first time, first verse in Quran. إقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق, خلق الإنسان من علق. اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم. The value of science comes first in Quran. This is another evidence from King Sulaiman's story, when he asked who can bring the throne of Balkis, Queen Balkis. Then the man who has science, scientific background, deeply rooted in science, was able to bring the throne that time. Immediately to King Sulaiman. What kind of science, whether it is laser technology or something, which we don't know exactly that time. But it was scientific, not magic. So in more than 10%, again in Quran, there are references to natural phenomena as science. However, there are two views about this matter, and a bit controversial, whether we consider Quran as a book which includes all kinds of knowledge and contain the basic ingredients of all the science of nature, or we consider Holy Quran as a book of guidance and there is no exact room for detailed physical and natural science in it. Some people support the first view and some people are toward the second view. Quran emphasized, this is very important, that wisdom and is a blessing that Allah has bestowed on whom He chooses. Thank you. So the verse of Quran is clear to say that لِأَلَّا يَعْلَمُ أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ أَلَّا يَقْدِرُونَ عَلَى شَيْءٍ مِّنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَإِنَّ الْفَضْلَ بِيَدِ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. So grace is entirely in His hand to bestow it on whomsoever He wills. So hikmah, wisdom, science is a blessing from Allah given to anyone, not a must to be a believer or non-believer. This is gift from Allah. يُؤْتِي الْحِكْمَةَ مَنْ يَشَاءُ, to whom who pleases. D, Quran orders all believers to seek the way, all means to know Allah. Now, today, we are in this session. is a part of our way to Allah. This is wasila to Allah. We hope that this work is blessed and considered as one of the means to know Allah. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وابتغوا إليه الوسيلة. Approach, seek all the means of approach to Allah. Islamic Sharia preserves, orders believers and Muslims to preserve the human life by all means. Self-preservation is approved by Islam and comes on top of the objectives of Sharia. So in Islam, there is no suicide. We cannot approve this. ولا تقتلوا أنفسكم إن الله كان بكم رحيما. There is no murder. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ولا تقتلوا أولادكم من إملاق نحن نرزقكم وإياهم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ولا تقتلوا النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق. No murder. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. من أجل ذلك كتبنا على بني إسرائيل أنه من قتل نفسا بغير نفس. Anyone killed a person not in retaliation of murder, this means that it would be as if he killed all mankind. This is very grave. Quran encourages man to develop and progress. And the verses are clear. هو الذي جعل لكم الأرض ذلولا فامشوا في مناكبها. Allah made the earth submissive to you. Go, search, enjoy, get the benefit. Then we come to the core part of this issue. What is the history of sciences in Islam? In Islam, science is the study of nature, nature and natural events. And it is integral part of the holistic outlook to the humanity. So, science was much developed in earlier Islamic age, in the golden Islamic age, because the guidance for Muslim scholar that time was very clear. This map shows the maximal extent of Islam during the golden age, from 7th century to 13th century, and it was very important when Muslims in Baghdad, in Iraq, established what is called the House of Wisdom. This was a translation center, could be the first in human life, in man history. A big translation center, which the purpose was just to translate and update the information from previous records, earlier civilization records. This is a great value of Muslim scholar, that they didn't demolish the earlier civilization records, but they preserved, updated, and translated. So, most of historians considered Islam, Islamic Empire, that time as a first universal ethical civilization, being able to preserve human records and invites cross-cultural networking by attracting non-Muslim intellectual to share in establishing novel scientific creativity in the Middle Ages that time. So, moreover, which it seems very interesting, that medical practice during the golden Islamic age included what is called continuing medical education, CME, which we are currently supporting CME in our institutes. Earlier hospital in Baghdad, Damascus, Cairo, during the golden age of Islam, were sites of medical education with lecture halls, libraries, and senior Muslim physician took juniors into hospital wards in a form of clinical rounds. This is proven, and there are some references in front of you. We come to this important point. Evidence-based practice in sciences have an earlier reference from Quran. How comes? We have Evidence-based medicine or evidence-based practice defined as a process of systematically reviewing, appraising, and using clinical research finding to support the delivery of clinical care to patients. And the basic principle of evidence-based medicine should treat where there is evidence to benefit and not to treat where there is no evidence to benefit. This is the modern definition. Come to what mentioned in Quran, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ولا تقف ما ليس لك به علم إن السمع والبصر والفؤاد كل أولئك كان عنه مسؤولا. Follow not that of which you have no knowledge. Don't jump to conclusion if you are not sure, if you don't have the sound evidence of your result. Please don't jump. This mentioned in Quran, 1,400 years more. So, in conclusion, why it was golden age with tremendous progress in science and medicine that time? Because Islam prohibits aggression against life, against anyone, properties, honor, regardless the face, position, or background of this person. And the fundamental tenet that Islam regarded every blessing, skill, and talent are gifts from Allah to anyone regards his background. Concepts of health in Islam. There is a word, term, called Islamic medicine. It is not ours, Muslims. It is also non-Muslims. Non-Muslims produced text about Islamic medicine, as you see. Being a holistic way of life, Islam supports and offers a system of physical, spiritual, emotional, social, and mental care. How comes? Muslims believe that treatment of patient is an obligation. This is fardun. You have to treat your patient, and the sick people should be treated, because we believe in our Prophet Hadith that there is no disease that Allah has sent down except that He also has sent down its treatment. There is cure, there is treatment, but the challenge is to search. Spend your time to search and look for remedies. Second component of concepts of Islam and health is hygiene. Hygiene and physical purities are mandatory in Islam. There are different evidences, as I show you now. إنه لقرآن كريم في كتاب مكنون لا يمسه إلا المطهرون, the purified. So Quran advises Muslim to uphold the highest standard of physical hygiene and to be ritually clean whenever possible. Three, there is diet laws, diet policy in Islam, which seems very healthy, and it comes in line with the milestones of Islam and health. Islam invites people to go for good quality, halal, with moderation of diet. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Eat and drink, but waste no excess, for Allah loves not the prodigals. Don't be musrif in food. There is therapeutic values of certain natural product. One of the example is honey, and everyone is clear what Allah mentioned about honey, that there is فيه شفاء للناس, there is healing for men in honey. The evidence from Malaysia. This is a picture of abstract of international conference held here in Malaysia 2006. The theme was the medicinal uses of honey from hive to therapy. So honey is studied in Malaysia. You have to know that. Spirituality in medical care. This is another fifth component of Islam and health. What is spirituality? Different definition. It is it could be defining the people who participating in organized religion or some personal approach like private prayer, yoga, meditation, and so on. But in Quran, spiritual health is mentioned clearly that the Quran is for those who believe a guide and healing, healing for souls. وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْعَالَمِينَ. So there is mercy, healing and mercy in Quran, spiritual. Professor Aziz Ahmed, Indian one, eminent psychiatrist, said that he, during his 38 years of experience in psychiatry, he found that counseling of any form of psychotherapy has to be in light of Holy Quran. And he mentioned this and he wrote a nice book in that, on that. From the world, every now and then we have these covers from Time and other journals, how faith can heal, spiritual aspect. NIH is National Institute of Mental Health. Mentioned that health professionals should take better account of patient religious belief. This one is important. I will leave for you for further revision. This overview of research and finding in spirituality, please refer to this. This is very important. It gives a physical evidence of how can spiritual support help in healing and treating difficult cases. So you have all evidences here, whether psychic or mental or even at molecular level, serum level of interleukin 6. This input from USIM. USIM now is supporting this study on the effect of Quran recitation on comatose patients. PhD, I am a great pleasure for me to be one of the supervisors. Last and very important, there are four of most controversial socio-medical issues got solution from Islam. Euthanasia in Islam, forbidden. لا تقتلوا أنفسكم إن الله كان بكم رحيما. We cannot support this. Mercy killing, no, haram. But Islamic Code of Medical Ethics, which is produced by WHO 2005, said that vegetative life has no meaning. So, Muslim doctor can stop trying to prolong life in cases where there is no hope of a cure. You have to be clear, the difference is critical. There is not mercy killing, but it is vegetative life with no hope. No need to continue. Stop any support. Health service inequality in modern medicine is imminent problem. Islam put the solution. يا أيها الناس إن خلقناكم من ذكر وأنثى وجعلناكم شعوبا وقبائل لتعارفوا. إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم. No difference between people. It's only referred to Allah, His activity and His work. So, but in life, no. No difference. Organ donation is very controversial. Islam, this again from Malaysia, very important comprehensive source by Ministry of Health on organ transplantation from the Islamic perspective, 2006. This is important publication. I hope everyone can get it. You can download from the website, 40 pages. And finally, it is very comprehensive and very, I am very much impressed with this kind of publication because the conclusion was very comprehensive, said that organ donors can be categorized under those who sacrifice their body and soul for human being, as mentioned. And this comes on the top of sacrification. وَتَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى. So the conclusion from this study to support to the maximum organ donation considering all Islamic rules. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قالوا سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا. ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا. ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا، أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات يهديهم ربهم بإيمانهم، تجري من تحتهم الأنهار في جنات النعيم، دعواهم فيها سبحانك اللهم وتحيتهم فيها سلام، وآخر دعواهم أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله.